Hi, everyone, and thank you for giving up your time this morning to listen to me chat. I hope I can offer some insights, and I'd be happy to answer any questions that you might have. I understand that Sherry will be making sure that any questions are answered. So please feel free to ask anything that you might be interested in, and I'd be happy to elaborate. As Leslie said, my name is Dr. Sarah Turin. I'm the program director for our transnational programs that I'll be talking to you about today. And I'll also be offering you some insights into how students and studying has been affected by the COVID-19 pandemic, as well as just how sport and tourism and event management have been affected by the COVID-19 pandemic. The whole world has obviously been affected, but there have been some really big changes to come out for these industries, and how they grow and move forward is really important to consider, because you guys will be the future of these industries if you're studying with us. So I'll start with some of the impacts. And I don't want us to try to think of them as being solely negative, but we've had a lot of social isolation. Obviously, we've had a lot of lockdowns. And one of the problems with isolation is that a lot of people have lost that sense of community, they've lost that sense of connection. If you're living in a small apartment, or if you're even living in a bigger house, because you can only interact with so many people at one given time. For us in Australia, we often had limits on how many people we could have over, whether or not we could go and see family. We were committed to a radius outside of our city, so we could only go within a 5-kilometre radius. And that kind of led to us losing a lot of the ways that we connect with people. If you think about sport and you think about tourism, you think about events, you think about recreation, you're interacting with people nearly on a daily basis. And all of a sudden, our modes of communication became only through technology. Our interaction only became through technology. And one of the big impacts that we saw from a student perspective was that's not enough. Students really like that face-to-face learning experience. Now, that's not to say online education can't be good. That's not to say online education can't be interesting and it can't be entertaining, but it's not as interactive as what it could be in the classroom. And the interaction and the social engagement that you get from 5 minutes in the classroom cannot replace and cannot be replaced with an hour-long Zoom session. I think we could all agree at the end, as we all adapt to this new normal, as you can see, that's one of the most overused terms of 2020 and 2021. But as we all adapt to this idea of a new normal, something that I think really can't be replaced is face-to-face interaction with people, having a quick phone conversation with somebody. I don't know about you guys, but we're all Zoomed out in Australia. We're pretty sick of the Zoom meetings. We're pretty sick of the emails and having to try to have a conversation via email. Emails are only good for kind of spreading information. They're one-way communication. It doesn't help to actually interact. So that's been one of the really big impacts. If we think about sport and recreation and events for a second, and specifically on these aspects, those are what bring people together. So when you attend a music festival, or you attend a soccer game or a cricket game, or you play tennis, or you go to one of the jockey clubs, you are doing things with other people that cannot be replaced by an online community. I'm not saying that there isn't a space for it, but I am saying we can't look at them as being one or the other. So that loss of community that sport and tourism and event management really facilitated was one of the really big impacts for our industries. Students got very fatigued by online learning. We saw a lot of students kind of switch off a little bit, and it's because it's difficult. It's hard to stay engaged on screen for an hour, 2 hours, 3 hours. So for us at the university, and I know Leslie can attest to this as well, it's been really difficult to try to keep everybody motivated and optimistic that this isn't going to be the future. We will be back in the classroom. We will get get you back doing things, because that is important. We want that, and we know that, we know our students want that as well. So that's been a challenge. One of the other really big impacts from COVID-19 on our sport and our tourism students has been the opportunity to build a community, but also to network with each other and engage in their placements. So one of the benefits of our programs are that students actually do a lot of the things that we're teaching them. They learn about events, they learn how to program an event, how to plan it, how to prepare, how to evaluate it. Students learn what it's like to work in a school and develop an entire school curriculum program for a sporting organization. All of these things our students actually have hands-on experience doing. And because COVID-19 forced us apart, it forced us to be at home by ourselves, not engaging in our own fitness, not engaging and keeping our own mental health on track, it's meant that our students haven't been able to network with each other as well as with the industry. So that's been a really big challenge for us to work through as well. And one of, I think, the biggest things that I've kind of touched on in the last 5 or so minutes is technology fatigue. Something I've learned, and, you know, no one is above learning. You know, we all have our own little learning challenges thrown at us. And something that I've learned is that emails are possibly one of the worst ways to communicate with each other. So much is lost in an email. Your tone, your expression, how you come across, your body language, all of that is lost. Emails are fantastic as almost like a for your information. This is what it is. But they don't facilitate a conversation. So we've seen a real technology fatigue and a lapse in how we communicate. There have been a lot of miscommunications through COVID-19 that could have been easily resolved by little conversations that you have with people face to face. Some of the most overused terms that we came across in Australia, and I think these are global if we look at it, is, you know, you have to be resilient. We need to be agile. We need to adapt. It's all about digitization and technology and moving forward. And again, I don't disagree with that. Technology is a fantastic way of staying connected, but we need to look at how we can go beyond that as well. And possibly my most hated term of the pandemic is this idea of a new normal. You know, we're adjusting to a new normal. Because we're all just having to live with COVID-19. So that's probably the impact there. Next slide, Sherry.
Okay.
Sorry. So some of the impacts, insights. Just to highlight the importance of sport, recreation, tourism, event management, it's estimated that the global sports industry is worth US $756 billion annually. So sport and tourism, recreation. So recreation is that overarching umbrella, and then sport and tourism and events all kind of sit under that broad level banner. When you think about all those things that come with sport, it's not just physical activity. It's your mental health. It's your emotional health. It's your social health. It's your spiritual health. Many studies have shown just by going on a long hike and being immersed in a lot of green trees and grass actually has an effect of uplifting our mood. Just being able to be in nature has a positive impact on our emotional stability and our emotional well-being. So during the COVID pandemic, because you were often limited to where you could go or what you could do or who you could engage with and how far, we missed all these benefits, all these periphery benefits that we get from sport, from event management, from tourism. They just weren't there. So we saw a lot of people suffering from a lack of emotional well-being, a lack of social well-being, physical well-being. And so now what I personally see is a huge growth opportunity for our sport and our tourism and our event industries, because more so than ever before, everyone has realized how important it is to be active. How important it is to go out and do things with people, because you never know if this is going to change or if you're going to get that opportunity. So all of a sudden, I know in Australia, you're seeing a lot more people engage with the community, embed themselves in activities so they can be part of the community because of these benefits and links to well-being. And that's a really, really big insight for you guys, because you will be the future of these industries. So how you start to provision sport, make provisions for events and for tourism will have a really big impact on the future growth of these industries. There are so many opportunities for you all. There's also the opportunity to embed technology within that, running more virtual sessions alongside face-to-face sessions. I know one thing that we did during the pandemic was virtual study tours. So even though students couldn't go on complete exchanges and visit countries and embed themselves in other countries, at UniSA we had them do these virtual exchanges and they could do virtual tours around the campuses. So there is always that role of technology, and for sport and for tourism, there's a real opportunity to kind of bring these industries into the 21st century and really embed technology and digitization as a part of these industries moving forward. We also saw an increased trend towards greater unorganized sport activities, as well as greater unorganized recreational activities. And this was a global thing that happened. So people moved away from that really organized club participation. You know, we train at this time and then our games are on at this time and you have to be here at this time. It was far more ad hoc. So we saw more people engage in walking, in hiking, in going for a run by themselves, again, because of these radiuses that we had in place. People wanted the freedom to be able to do what they wanted to do when they wanted to do it. And again, that could be a response to having so much government control placed on us, placed on our movements, that people don't want to be answering to a higher power for their sport and their tourism activities. And so that was a bit of a trend. These were, if we look at just sport and tourism for a second again, these were two industries that really suffered from the pandemic because you couldn't have people brought together. And what I noticed, and what a lot of my colleagues in the sport and tourism industry noticed as well, was there was a yearning for being able to engage with it. People missed sport. I mean, yes, we talked about social interaction on that first page, but people missed their sport. They missed their recreation. They missed traveling. One of the first things people have wanted to do since this pandemic is travel. This mobility is huge. So again, for you guys, this is fantastic. Just that growth aspect of these industries is really amazing. And looking forward, I think there's going to be a lot of opportunities for everyone. Next slide.
Okay.
So what will you study? And I'm sure Leslie will touch on this a little bit more. As I said, you can see a few photos of students in the classroom. This was one of the events that they've actually picked. And they're doing a cup game. But these are the core 8 specialisation courses that you would study as part of your tourism and event management degree. It's important to know, and again, Leslie will probably elaborate on this more than what I will do, but it's a one-year top-up degree. So students will study these courses in an accelerated mode of study, but these are the specialised courses that will give you a unique understanding of the tourism and event management industry, and they'll give you an insight as to where you want to go in that industry. Do you want to be an event manager? Do you want to coordinate? Do you want to work for travel agents? Do you want to set travel policy? Do you want to be part of a sustainable tourism ecological destination? Do you want to make provisions for that? Do you want to be one of the pioneers and entrepreneurs and try to embed tourism with more digital capacity? All of these aspects will be touched on within your specialization. And it's similar for your sports. So next slide, Sherry. Sorry. Thank you. So for your sport, these are, again, your 8 units of specialization. There'll be an extra four business courses there. And Leslie will touch on that in more detail. But you guys will have a bit of a unique understanding of all the aspects of sport and of tourism by studying these eight specialized courses. How to be a leader in the sport industry, how to become a coach, how to be inspiring and motivating, how to be an urban planner and make provision for sporting areas. And in Hong Kong, that's a really big opportunity because there's so much population density. How do you make the most use of your space? How do you make the most use of green buildings and providing areas of grass and areas for unorganized sport opportunities during the working day? That would be a huge growth area within moving forward. How to actually design, prepare, plan, run, and evaluate an event, whether or not it was successful. All of these aspects are what we teach our students in our Hong Kong top-up degree. And this is exactly mirrored in our onshore program. So students who study with me on campus at UniSA do these same eight specialized courses that you guys are doing. And so it's really important. You're part of a community. By being at UniSA and studying with us and being part of Hong Kong Baptist University and studying a UniSA degree that we do collaboratively, you are part of a bigger community. And that's something to be really proud of and inspired by. If you wanted to come to Australia, there's mobility that we can arrange, we can look into. And that's something to be proud of and be excited about, given that we can now start to travel a little bit more. These are the core business courses that you study. So on top of those eight specialized courses that all students do, you'll also study these main business courses, which will give you those foundation, those added foundation details from what you guys already know. Remember, it is studied in accelerated mode, so you will be completed your top-up degree within 1 year. So some of the areas that you may seek to find employment in and you may become employed, or some of the areas you might become employed in, is a sport development officer, marketing communications coordinator, business advisor, entrepreneur. You may work for local government. You may work for a professional sporting organization. You may work for a multinational organization. These degrees have a lot of flexibility to take you wherever you want to go in your future career. And because you have those business courses as a foundation, and all of you guys studying will have those business courses as a foundation, if you want to run your own business and be an entrepreneur and make new opportunities, you have all of the skills and abilities to be able to do that. And next slide. Okay, so this is probably my favorite slide. I often get asked the question of, well, how, and a lot of my domestic students or my on-campus students have asked me, well, how do I get a job? I want to walk away. I want to become employed. I want a job. Every student wants a full-time job. And as we know, the economic situation both in Hong Kong and Australia at the moment is all very scary. It's a scary world out there. So being able to enhance your employability is something that everyone needs to pay attention to. So these are my top tips. And I would really encourage you all to think about these when entering into your degree. Get to know your lecturers and your academic staff. Make the time to have a conversation with Leslie. Make the time to talk to Sherry. Know your administrators. Have after class, introduce yourself. Let your lecturers and your coordinators know what area of the sport and tourism industry you might want to work in. The minute you do that, you are putting yourself on your lecturer's radar. I always remember the students that have taken the time to come and speak to me, and not speak to me because they want something, because they want an extension, or they want more time, or they want me to do this for them, or they want that. But they've just taken the time to come and introduce themselves and let me know a little bit about who they are. And do you know what? When I remember them, when those jobs come up, they're the names I put forward for those jobs. They're the students that get invited back to come and do these conversations that build their resume up. They're the students that if I'm speaking to a colleague in the sport or tourism industry, and 90% in Australia, just a little statistic here, 90% of the jobs in the sport and the tourism industry are unadvertised. People are hired because they know people. So if I'm talking to a colleague in the sport industry and they say, oh, Sarah, do you know any recent graduates that are looking for jobs? Do you have any good names that you could recommend? I will always be able to recommend the ones that have come and made a good impression on me, not the students that tend to ask for extensions and I don't hear from until week five when all the assignments are due and I get the email saying, can I have an extension? And I've never met this student before. And that student is not going to get put up for the job. So you need to start thinking about your uni career from the minute you enter university. How do you want to set yourself up for success? No one can do it for you. And this is, it's really all about your soft skills here. Nobody will do this for you and nobody can do it for you. Myself, Leslie, Sherry, we can't make you more employable. You need to take these skills on yourself. So remember, first impressions matter. If the first time you're engaging with your lecturer is because you want something and you haven't come to class or you haven't been around, then you need to consider what kind of impression that leaves. You need to consider what your lecturer or coordinator could say about you. That is something you need to think about from the minute you start your university career. I call it a university career. Start to volunteer early. So I guarantee you, Leslie and all of your lecturers are very well connected with industry in Hong Kong. They will know of volunteering experience. They will know of people that want students to be a part of things. And unless you are engaging with your lecturers, you won't get the opportunity to build your resume with these volunteering experiences. When you go to a job interview, you need to be able to have examples of when you've done this or how you could do this. People don't get hired by just saying, I think I could do that. I think it would be great if I got that opportunity. You need to have an example of when I was at university, I volunteered for the Hong Kong Jockey Club and I had the opportunity to be able to work on this event. It was a large scale event and I was in charge of managing all the volunteers. That is a tangible example that if you're in an interview, someone would go, this person knows how to do things. I reckon they would be a good fit for our organization. So that comes to my point of always use examples. Don't discount any opportunity. I love students that are eager, and again, it speaks to the student, that are eager to engage with everything and anything that uni has to offer. Your university has so many wonderful facilities and clubs available to you. Engage in them. Make the most of it. Join the clubs, join fencing, join parkour, engage with swimming, engage with athletics. Be a part of your university career and really start to set that tone, because you will miss those opportunities when you're not at university. They also help to build your resume. So if you can say that you were part of the Hong Kong Baptist Fencing Club and you arrange trainings and social catch-ups on these evenings, that is a really amazing thing to be able to have on your resume that then goes to your employability. These are very small things to do that go a very long way. These are possibly the easiest things students could do. And yet, if I had to put a number on it, I would say only 5% of students on campus do it. 5%. And all of that 5% of our students that do it are employed. I have a number of students at the moment who have got jobs in their second year of their degree because they did these few things that I was talking about, and they are now in such hot demand and we have such an employment shortage, the industry is screaming out for more of them because they're so wonderful. So I think these are the really big things to take away to enhance your employability and also to think about as you move into your degree. So that's my presentation, guys. Are there any questions? I'd be happy to answer absolutely anything.
Thank you. Thank you so much for the insightful sharing and the top tips for students of Dr. Cha. Thank you very much, Sarah. I think the students may need to develop, besides developing their solid knowledge and soft skills are very important if you want to proceed your career after graduation. Thank you very much for the top tips for the students. And to see if any questions from audiences. Or if anyone who have questions or students who have questions later, please feel free to send us an email or call us anytime. We are so much appreciated to answer any questions relating to your studying or your career, how the career prospect in sport industry. Thank you very much. And following the inspiring talks from Dr. Sarah Cha, we will have our alumni, Mr. Samson Poon, to share with us his study in UniSA and his work after graduation. Hello, Assam. Hey, thank you for coming today. Thank you.
Yes.
Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes.
Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes.即係喺中學裏邊做一個教學助理嗰啲啦，咁普遍上老師準備即係要準備嘅所有嘅教材啊，嗰啲嘅唔同嘅即係可能學生嘅活動啊，都係我去協幫手去處理，甚至可能係我係去做一個 host 咁樣去控制曬成個場面點樣去 run 得盡快係暢順啊咁樣咯。
其實咧，Samson 咧係我嘅學生嚟㗎，咁啊上年就 graduate 啦，咁一個好勤力嘅同學啦，咁樣亦都係好願意去分享啦，好願意咧去將佢喺可能喺呢一個課堂咧喺個 program 上面學到嘅嘢咧都 apply 落去喎。咁我都想問下啦，咁其實咧成個課程你覺得有啲咩優點？
成個課程其實係個優點其實係變相人哋讀四年一個 degree， 我哋而家係即係high dip 咗，即係我本身係 high dip 啦，即係 BU 嘅 high dip， 咁就再加多一年嘅 top degree， 咁就三年，相對地呢一個咁樣嘅 range 上面就會比同年齡嘅人就會快咗一年去完成咗讀到一個 degree 出嚟咯。
嗯，咁喺個過程
有多一年。
哦，你繼續講 ，sorry 啊。
咁就會即係多一年去俾你自己去做多一做多少少嘅 prepare for 你future 咁樣咯。
咁其實你覺得讀得開唔開心啊？老師幫唔幫到你啊？嗰啲教學感覺你覺得點樣咧？即係呢個 mix mode 咁樣，即係有香港老師又有外國澳洲老師。
其實咁樣其實都幾好嘅，因為最主要係可能香港 lecturer 嗰啲就比較可能會。主要是 focus 咗喺 local 咁樣啦，咁可能有埋其他外國 lecturer 佢哋嘅角度去睇於香港我哋嘅情況，甚或者可能佢哋有佢哋嘅睇法，去點樣對於呢一個世界嗰個整體觀點樣去即係應用翻喺我哋嘅課堂上面嘅所有知識啊，甚或者可能其實去到我哋現時即係去到出嚟做嘢嘅時候，都係會用到喺上面咯。但係就最主要係個 mix mode 就係我哋係要適應翻去用UNRC 嗰邊嗰個嘅 system 啦。咁最主要其實係喺翻嗰個 system 上面嗰個 check 嘅系統上面，就去揾翻喺南澳嗰邊嘅 lecturer 去問翻佢哋，可能有啲關於課堂上面佢哋講嘅知識，我哋唔太明嘅，可能即係要透過嗰個 system 先至可能揾到佢哋，所以就可能最主要係要習慣翻嗰個 system 咯。其實習慣咗之後，都係會相對地容易用啊，甚至可能想容易去同揾翻嗰啲 lecturer 去問翻嗰啲相關嘅知識嗰啲咯。
好好喎、啊。咁其實你覺得成個課程喺你工作上邊咧，其實apply到即係你學到嘅 knowledge 喺個書本上邊，同埋一啲嘅可能係互動啊、實習上邊，咁其實喺工作上邊apply到用到咧？
都 apply 到嘅，即係特別 for example， 其實我而家係做緊關於學生嘅潛能發展啦。咁相對地，即係佢哋有啲係關於即係學生去 train 啲學生領袖出嚟啊，成啊咁樣。咁我再結合埋我以前學到嘅嘢啦，甚或者係我喺呢一個 program 裏邊學到嘅所有嘅關於 leadership 啊，甚或者去點樣去 control 住嗰個event 啊，令到佢成個 time management 啊，成所有嘅 run down 啊。裏面和那些 paper 上面的處理都是會令到可以即我自己也都有得著，甚至是可以將這些相關的知識也都給埋我需要跟那些學生那些相關的領袖學生去講，讓他們也都可以得到相關的知識，令到我自己那個相對的處理這些方面的東西都會方便到我自己咯。
好好啊，好啦，咁啊，可能啲同學咧，或者我哋嘅今日喺我哋呢一個嘅聽我哋呢個講座嘅朋友仔咧，可能咧佢哋都好關心嘅問題，佢哋都會想知道究竟喺十二個月裏面讀呢一個嘅十二科嘅科目啦，咁其實功課多唔多，同埋難唔難讀噶？
其實唔會話難讀嘅，其實最主要係睇下你有冇一個去願意去。學習不同的知識的一個心態咯，即係可能話你如果你話喂，我其實想報呢、這個，淨係齋為咗去拎呢一個 degree 嘅，其實就可能就會相對地會浪費咗一年，因為你呢一個 program 連埋 high 啲咁樣嘅話，其實你三年已經讀到一個 degree， 其實已經算係比即係好似我頭先咁講啦，即係比同年人即係快咗一步啦。咁你多咗一年去做 prepare， 咁對於你嘅未來嘅計劃啊、成啊，都會相對地會好好多咯。但係如果你話就咁 hea 住讀咗呢一年嘅，咁當然你功課上面嗰啲咁一定係追唔上啦，因為你根本就 hea 住嚟讀，咁就冇一個心態就係話喂，我要係去得到呢一方面嘅知識，咁我就想。知道多啲嘅，咁其實你可以上網 search 咗好多唔同嘅 resources， 特別而家疫情呢個階段啦，純粹靠 online 嘅 online lesson 啊，甚至可能有啲嘢 face to face lesson 啊，其實都可能爭少少嘅，即係你可能你上網其實 search 到嘅可能唔同嘅知識都可能都有機會應用到落去呢一科度。其實如果你肯上網去 search 下唔同資料，對於你嚟講，其實功課啊嘅密集程度啊，同埋你嘅難度啊，都係會應付得到咯。
咁喺嗰個即係喺嗰個可能係做功課啊嗰啲，咁其實老師幫唔幫到你哋啊？
都幫到啊，特別好似 Leslie 咁樣，我都好多謝你先，因為好似我哋可能課堂上面有啲嘅知識唔明啊，即係可能關於assignment 啊嗰方面嘅資訊，我哋都即係可能都會問下你哋唔同嘅 lecturer， 都可能得到唔同嘅方面嘅知識，去令到我哋處理得更加順暢啦，甚至可能啲 group project 嗰啲咁大家都係即係大家一 group 咁樣就互相協助，咁就相對地會好容易咁樣去處理曬嗰啲嘅 assignment 咯。
好啊，多謝你啊，三哥，今日好多謝你嗰、那個分享同我哋啦，咁啊都等啲同學仔都知道啊，原來我哋個課程裏邊咧，咁其實都多元化啦，咁同埋咧其實都係可以咧，同學都係可以咧，基本上係一個好開心嘅環境，好愉快嘅環境，同埋都係 handle 到嘅環境咧，去學習咁樣嘅，咁啊多謝曬你阿森，咁就
好
啦，係，咁就好啦，咁我哋咧其實頭先阿森啊，咁同埋咧我哋嘅講者，咁啊頭先我哋嘅 program director Dr. Sarah Chua 啦，咁都有講過啦，咁其實就係我哋呢個 program 咁就十二個月啦。12個月咁啊，讀十二科，咁其實有8個嘅 specialization 啦，咁我哋本身喺香港 offer 嘅嗰個嘅 program 咁有2個啦，咁係呢個 Bachelor of Business 嘅 Sport and Recreation Management 啦，咁啊呢個嘅體育及康樂管理啦，咁同埋 Bachelor of Business 嘅 Tourism and Event Management 啦，咁啊呢一個嘅旅遊及呢一個嘅可能係節目嘅管理咁啦，咁其實咧主要咧其實 UniSA 喺香港就 provide 咗呢兩個，咁其實呢個兩個都係一啲好熱門同埋好即係對於嗰即係 well equipped with 嗰、那個工作的環境裏面，因為剛才 Sarah 都有講過，其實在香港裏面 Sports 呢其實就大家越來越覺得是很重要，還有這個 business 的個潛力真的很大很大，啊，大家都會知道，啊，可能會有這個的啟德體育園啦，樣啊，其實現在其實他們已經請了人，其實請緊人 一路咁請，咁其實已經有人已經翻緊工去密羅緊股去做緊，咁其實成個嘅 development 會好大，咁亦都政府亦都有推好多嘅，可能係除咗精英運動之外啦，咁而家亦都推好多嘅，可能係社區嘅 community sports 啦，喺呢個社會嘅社區嘅層面裏邊去推呢個 sports 啦，啊，咁啊同埋面對住呢個嘅齡嘅老化啦，咁好多人都注重個身體健康啦，咁其實喺呢一個嘅唔同嘅範疇裏邊咧，都會有好大嘅潛力。咁喺呢一個嘅課程裏邊，咁頭先阿 Sarah 都有講過，有八個嘅 specialization 啦，咁其實就 cover 嗰個 spectrum 咧就好廣泛嚇。咁啊，無論喺呢個 sports 裏邊咧，喺 recreation 裏邊咧 ，leisure 裏面啦，啊，無論係可能係一啲嘅關於呢一個嘅 marketing 啊，其他嘅可能係一個 urban 喺一個市區裏邊啊，咁香港點樣利用香港呢個咁密集嘅環境裏邊咧，係製造呢個契機出嚟咧，咁去推廣呢個 sports。OK 嚇。因為在咁細嘅環境裏邊有咁多嘅人咧，其實咧成個潛力真係好大好大，即係唔係話可能好似外國咁樣咁，其實好大嘅地方可能嘅人口即係相對於每一個嘅每一點嘅地方，其實就唔係太多人咁。但係香港就好密集嘅，基本上你可能係 focus 喺某一個地區咧，其實咧基本上都已經有好多嘅你有好多嘅 target groups 咧，其實已經係可以做到咁啊。tourism 嘅 event management 咁，其實旅遊咧，咁其實咧，隨住呢一個嘅疫情嘅發展咧，咁其實咧，老實講咧，咁其實亦都有好多嘅發展，即係會好多嘅復甦會喺入邊啦。咁其實咧，都係一個非常之 OK 有潛力啊 ，OK 嚇，係非常之有潛力嘅一個嘅範疇嚟嘅。咁另外啦，咁其實咧 ，UNISA 咧佢提供嘅 program 咧，其實咧有兩個嘅認證咧，咁 which 咧喺香港裏邊咧都係唔多嘅，咁可能係除咗即係可能我哋 BU 啦，咁同 UNISA 啦咁樣，咁呢個係得可能係中大、港大嗰啲係會有雙重嘅認證。咁佢邊雙重認證咧？咁就係呢個嘅ACRIS 啦，咁樣同埋 AACSB 啦。咁其實咧都係 rank top 1% 嘅 institution 啦，其實先至係會有呢一個咁嘅認證嘅。所以其實咧大家唔需要擔心，可能係呢一個嘅課程。哇！究竟嗰個認受係點啊？咁啊 ，O 唔 OK 啊？咁其實就唔需要太擔心嘅。咁其實係 very international 嘅，啊 ，very international 啦。咁啊，除咗喺香港有呢個嘅我哋叫資歷架構嘅第五級認證之外啦，咁亦都係有呢一個嘅 international 嘅認可咁。咁所以大家可能無論喺香港啊，或者去到外國發展啊，咁其實你攞住呢個嘅degree 咧，其實去到外國人亦都會認識呢個嘅院校，認識呢一個嘅 degree。咁對於大家可能係 career 嘅 development 咧，都會有一個好好嘅幫助嘅。好啊，唔該 ，Cherry 可以 next 啦。係。咁就大家都會關心啦。啊，咁其實我去即係讀呢一個嘅top degree 咁樣，咁其實究竟可唔可以享用到啲設施啊？究竟係咪淨係讀書啊？咁其實唔係嘅，咁其實係可以 enjoy 到我哋 campus 嘅 facility 同埋 services 啦。咁啊，除咗呢一個嘅 sport facilities 啊，咁大家亦都可以用到我哋嘅 library 啦。咁唔止我哋嘅 library 啦，唔止 BU 嘅 library 啦，係 UDSA 嗰個嘅 library 嘅 database 咧都係可以 access 嘅。咁所以大家做功課唔需要太過擔心，係啊。咁變咗都有好多嘅資訊，好多海量嘅資訊，好多嘅資源咧係可以 support 到你嗰個嘅learning 啦，咁好似頭先阿森所講啦，咁其實喺一年裏邊咧去study 嘅唔同嘅科目啦，其實就好多都係個可能係 group project 啦，咁大家都係有好多練習到大家協作嘅能力啦，咁 which 咧都係去到呢個 soft skills 咧，去到工作上邊咧，好似 Sarah 所講嘅都係好需要嘅一個soft skills 啦，咁啊。同時我哋亦都有呢個 medical 同 dental 嘅 benefits 啦，嚇咁啊，即係呢個醫療啦，咁樣咁啊，同埋 academic counselling 啦，咁其實隨時好 feel free 去揾我嘅 ，OK 嚇，揾我啊，或者揾其他嘅老師啊 ，lecturer 又或甚至乎咧係可能係 online onshore 嘅老師啊，譬如 Sarah 咁，其實佢哋都係一個好 helpful， 佢哋都係好 helpful 嘅老師，咁佢哋都可以係俾到好多大家唔同嘅意見，無論可能喺香港啦，可能香港嘅就業嘅前景係點樣啦，有冇咩工作介紹啊咁樣，咁可以揾我啦。咁你話啊唔係喎，其實我都想去外國 explore， 可能甚至乎去澳洲去 explore 下喎。咁我相信咧，呢個 onshore 嘅老師啦，咁即係呢一個可能 Dr. Sarah 啊，可能其他嘅老師都係好好，佢哋都係俾到，佢哋本身都係喺業界裏邊啦，咁有個好好嘅 networking 啦，咁跟住再去嚟教書啊，所以大家都會係有好多嘅資源啊、資訊啊，可以俾到大家嘅咁樣。咁好啊，next slide 唔該 ，Cherry。 咁其實咁大家都會可能都會關心啊，究竟嗰個嘅financial assistance 嗰度係點啊？即係可能係學費啊，其他有冇其他嘅 support 啊咁樣。咁其實咧咁其實同埋香港大部分院校都好似㗎啦。咁其實我哋都會有 normal 嘅 test loan 啦，有關 loan 啊，有呢一個嘅 CEF 啊，咁甚至乎咧係呢個 government scholarship 咧。咁其實咧都係可以，其實我哋都有嘅呢個嘅 top degree， 所以大家都唔需要擔心。OK 啊，即係究竟個 financial 啊有冇 support 啊？咁係有嘅。咁而且亦都係非常之同香港嘅其他嘅 institution 都 comparable 嘅。咁其實都會有呢個嘅 SPSS 啦 ，self financing 嘅 post secondary 嘅 scholarship 嘅 scheme 啦，咁樣咁啊，我哋會有四個啦，咁樣咁啊，其實呢一個嘅 OPS 啦，即係成績最好嘅學仔啦，咁可以申請啦，咁樣咁啊，另亦都除咗成績好之外，咁啊，其實可能我喺運動上邊有好好嘅 achievement 喎，啊咁啊，有其他嘅 talent 喎，咁樣咁我哋都會有個 TDS 啦 ，talent development scholarship 啦，咁係可以俾學仔咁樣去申請啦。咁另外有個 reaching out work 啦，嚇咁啊，即係可以係有呢一個嘅scholarship 咧，就係關於啊，可能大家可能啊都會想去其他地方咁樣去 explore 多啲，咁啊做下啲exchange 啊，做下啲site做下啲 overseas 嘅 tour 啊，即係睇翻究竟啊佢啊嗰個 city tour 係點啊，其他外國嘅學習環境係點啊，咁我哋都會有呢一個嘅 scholarship 俾大家同學仔去申請啦。咁仲有個 endeavor 嘅 scholarship 咧，咁會俾同學仔去申請嘅。next slide 啊，唔該，好啦，咁仲有咧，咁喺呢個2022年新嘅，咁啊同學仔今年入學咧，咁就又多一個嘅 scholarship 咧，俾同學仔去申請喎。咁啊呢個就叫做 international merit 嘅 scholarship 啦，咁樣。咁UNISA 咧就會有八個嘅 international merit 嘅 scholarship 啦，咁就係俾成績最好 highest achieving 嘅頭八位嘅同學仔啦。咁樣佢如果係繼續佢嘅學業啊，喺呢一個嘅 UNISA 嘅 top up degree 咧，喺我哋 BU 裏邊咧，咁咧就會有呢一個嘅 scholarship 噶啦。咁呢個 scholarship 咧就會咧每一個嘅 scholarship 咧，咁會有$10,000嘅，咁啊由佢哋嗰個學費裏邊咧去做翻個減免咁嘅。唔該 ，Cherry。咁其實咧，咁同學仔都可能會問啦，哇，其實咧我都好想讀呢個 degree， 咁但我又好想去澳洲喎，咁其實咧，喺 UNISA 同我哋嘅 partnership 裏邊咧，咁其實咧同學仔都可以選擇可能喺最後嗰個一年啦，或者最後嗰半個最後嗰一個 sem 啦，咁咧都可以選擇啊，可能會想喺嗰度做嗰個嘅畢業，或者想喺嗰度讀佢哋嘅 degree 喎，咁樣喺嗰邊 onshore 去讀喎，咁係可以嘅 onshore studies。咁同學仔係可以 apply 嘅，咁同我哋去 contact 翻就 OK， 咁嘅 Cherry 都會幫到你咧去做翻一系列嗰個嘅 administrative 嘅 procedures 啦。咁另外啦，咁我哋 UNISA 有個 exchange program 啦，咁喺其實喺疫情前我哋都一路有做開嘅嚇。咁students 咧其實係可以去enroll 呢一個 exchange program 啦。咁到時咧嗰個嘅 ROA 啦，咁個 reaching out award 啦，咁相信大派用場啦，咁樣咁可以喺我哋嗰個嘅 exchange program 裏邊咧，咁可以去到外國咁去睇翻究竟啊，其實喺外國其實嗰個體驗下呢個喺外國嘅讀書嘅生活係點樣啦，咁樣嚇。唔該 ，Cherry。咁其實而家我哋已經接受報名啦，大家只要覺得係有興趣嘅 ，OK 嚇。頭先聽咗覺得啊，其實都幾好喎，咁其實就真係都唔錯嘅，因為其實頭先阿森都有講過啦，其實我哋呢個 program 就集合咗 local 嘅老師嘅一啲嘅資源啊，同埋佢嘅 knowledge 啦，同埋佢嘅 network 啦，咁亦都係 combine with 咧呢一個 onshore 老師啦，佢哋嘅世界觀啦 ，international perspective 啦，咁同埋咧佢哋嘅 networking， 咁所以咧，如果大家同學仔咧想了解多啲可能外國嘅即究竟係點啊，成個世界觀嘅喺 sports 裏邊係點樣，喺 tourism event 係點啊，咁其實都係好適合咧係讀呢個嘅 program 嘅。咁大家同學仔咧可以係打電話嚟俾我哋啦，3411914啦，咁我哋有專門嘅同事去接聽啦，咁有問題嘅話咧，都即係關於 academic 咧，咁樣其實都會 refer 俾我哋相關嘅 lecturer 啦，咁啊可能係我啦，咁樣或者其他老師啦，咁去做翻大家嘅解答啦，咁啊，咁啊另外亦都可以 send 電郵俾我哋啦，咁樣咁啊有個電郵地址啦，咁樣咁亦咁啊大家都會見到咁有啲 QR code 啦，大家 scan 咗咧，其實咧都係可以去到我哋嘅相關嘅地方咧，咁去睇翻多啲嘅資訊資料嘅。 咁好啦，咁我今日嗰個嘅 presentation 咧就暫時到呢一度啦。咁我都想睇翻咧，其實同學仔咧有冇其他嘅問題，咁其實想問咧，咁其實隨便問，係啊，咁其實我知道嘅，咁我都係會誒盡量去答大家嘅。唔該曬。
唔該曬 Leslie， 提提大家啦。咁九月開學嘅課程，咁如果有興趣報我哋嘅課程咧，就盡量喺六月之內就六月底之內咧就交翻個 application 俾我哋咁樣啦。係啦，咁係啦，咁今日咧我哋都有 chat room 嘅，如果諗起啲咩問題咧，都可以隨時打落個 chat room 度問我哋啦。咁如果之後嘅日子咧，就歡迎大家就打電話或者 email 啦，又或者再去我哋去 follow 我哋個 IG， 咁睇我哋嘅最新消息嘅。